I'm Drake Bell, and my new album is called It's Only Time. It comes out December 5th.
It's only time until you find out. It's only time.
You know, it's very Beatles influenced and Queen and the Beach Boys, and it's, you know, very upbeat and positive, and it's really musical. You know, it's really dense musically. So.
That's just my way. Saying that I love you. Life is like a bowl of cherries, not so very ordinary, overflowing with love. And I can never want for more unless I do, because before I'm in three. And if we find me, baby, give me a sign, give me a reason, make up your mind.
New video, I know.
It's retro. I play two characters. I play one who's very Bob Dylan-ish, who's into in the music for the art, and then another character who is this very outrageous, just loves the life and all the models around him and everything. And sort
Jay
of
Boogie.
How, yeah, exactly. Just sort of how those two worlds clash, and see the different sides of that. It was just the same as shooting my video. You know, it's like. There's a lot that gets done in 2 days. You know, you don't realize, like, wow, you go from this location to here, to like all in one day, and listening to the same song over and over and over again. But you know, it helped me when I went to do my video, because it's like I've been there, done that.
You kind of secretly had done one before.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Your character in the video. Big record collector, big record fan, you know, some record store. Do you actually collect vinyl, or are you a fan of that sort
of
thing?
Oh, totally, totally, totally. I actually have more vinyl than I have CDs, I think.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, I grew up I just love the way they sounded, and they were so much fun, the big album artwork, and they'd usually come with, like, a poster inside or something, you know. And so I was just, I'm definitely much more of a vinyl.
So you wrote the theme song for Drake and Josh, your show on Nickelodeon.
Yep.
And that ends up on the album, correct?
Yes.
I never thought that it'd be so simple, but I found a way, I found a way. And I always thought that it'd be too crazy, but I found a way, I found a way.
When you're writing for the album, do you think this will be great for the show, or do you write for the show and think this will be great for the album? How do you pick and choose what's going where?
For Zoe 101 and Drake and Josh, we do
all
the...
Yes, because he writes for Zoe 101 as well. Little entrepreneur over here.
We do all the score and the music for it, and actually, like, makes me happy, which is on the new record. As a cue, and we were like, hey, this actually sounds like a cool song. We should turn this into a full-length thing. And put it on the record.
Falling For You is really personal. I mean, it's like, it's a fun, upbeat, happy song, but still, it's definitely like the entire course of a relationship I was in and everything, and kind of, you know, it's very personal.
The first time I saw you, I thought you were barefoot. Your hair was pulled back, your jelly shoes, I was wondering if I should. Like, about my age.
With like songs like Falling For You and Rusted Silhouette and Break Me Down and End It Good, like that sweet at the end, it's like, we had these songs forever, and we finally were talking about, before we were making the record, about how about making all of these songs just one song, because they all kind of have the same rhythm, and they all, you know, we can find transitions that go, you know. So I was like, man, that would be the coolest thing. So we worked out making it just one long song with it, and then putting End It Good at the end, and recording End It Good was just so much fun. We had a friend.
I'll take your side.
like Mildred Davis.
Professions where you get a lot of fans. Mm-hmm. Have you seen the difference between the sort of TV fans and the music fans? Do you feel a little bit maybe closer to the music fans because they are?
Well, it's kind of crossing over, you know. I mean, it's like the music fans are the TV fans, and the TV fans are the music fans. But it's really cool because a lot of the fan mail and all that, instead of the first line saying, "Oh, your show's great, we love you," blah, 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 you know, it's like, "When did you start playing guitar? I started playing guitar because of you," and like, "I'm writing songs now too." And it always starts with the music. So, you know, it's like really cool to see like that's what's grabbing the young audience. You know, it's like the music, you know, it's not just the two funny brothers, you know.
Exactly. Tactile feeling of cracking something open and smelling it and
yeah,
opening it and stuff like that.
That's what I tried to
is
do.
Is that important?
This, yeah, I mean, that's what I tried to do with this record because, you know, and that's the thing is, you know, you could just go on and download or do whatever, but I wanted there to be more for, like, you know, because when you go and, like I said, you go get Sgt. Pepper, you go get something on vinyl, it's this great artwork, you know, you open it up, you fold it open, it's like all the lyrics, and just, it's like a big. It's like it's all part of it, not just the music, you know. And so for this record, I actually went in and really worked with this these awesome guys, actually the two directors for the video. One of them was a photographer and the other one designed it with me, and it's really cool. It's like I'm trying to think, it's like the Jetsons almost. It's kind of futuristic but retro, so how you know, like things look futuristic, but instead it's like a tape machine, you know, instead of like digital and stuff. So it's really cool. We're in like a submarine lounge in one of them, and there's a, you know, like conveyor belt with me going into like this recording pod studio thing, and it's really cool and colorful and a lot of stuff going on like every page. So, and it comes with the DVD and all sorts of fun stuff. So don't download it, buy it.